Gail, one local political leader was on the plane with the president.
That is right. Orlando Mayor Buddy Dyer has been attending a conference of mayors in Washington, D.C. He just kind of like caught a ride on U.S. Air Force One, along with another dignitary, U.S. Secretary John Bryson. He is the Secretary of Commerce. Now, this is interesting and also a pinnacle for this report or the speech that the president's going to give, because he's going to talk about bolstering tourism. He's going to talk about easing the visa travels as far as the visas are concerned. Some people, especially Brazilians that we've talked to right here visiting Central Florida, says it takes up to 3 months or longer just to try to get an interview once they've received an application. Well, the president and others want to try to cut that, you know, time a whole lot better than that. Joining me live now is Carolyn Fennell with Orlando International Airport. One thing that the airport has been trying to do, obviously, is bolster tourists, especially from areas like Brazil, right?
Absolutely. Working with our community partners and working with our board and the mayor and other members of the community, we've had strong focus on Latin America and the potential there. Two flights now by TAM have added a 41% increase in Brazilian travelers. Imagine what it would be if there was easier access. And that adds the trickle effect to the economy, because the Brazilians stay longer, they spend more, they're in the malls, and they go into our restaurants. So it does matter, not just to the airport and the tourism community, but it matters to our entire economy.
They do love the Sunshine State, don't they?
Yes, they do, and we want them to keep coming.
All right, thank you so much. You know, by estimates, just by the Brazilians alone in 2010, it is estimated that there were like a little over a million Brazilian tourists here to Central Florida, to the Sunshine State. And that created more than $1 billion. That's money, as Carolyn Fennell mentioned, coming in here to Central Florida, to the state of Florida. Bottom line now, again, once the president finishes his speech, he's going to hop right back on Air Force One, and then he's going to go through a number of fundraisers. One includes the Apollo Theater, where he's going to be there. He's going to be graced by the likes of Al Green and India Arie for a particular fundraiser there. I'm Gail Pascoe-Brown, live at OIA for WESH 2 News.
Gail, thanks. The visit from the president is creating some big traffic problems. This is the route the president is using between the airport and Disney World. The motorcade is going from the airport down the beach line at State Road 528 to I-4 and into the Magic Kingdom from there. So you can look for tie-ups between now and his departure a little after 2 o'clock today.
The president's